Is you Midoriya X listener? The name of this is Panic. Someone wanted a anxiety comfort, but I couldn't find one, and it was the closest I could find. They aren't very close, but I tried. I can actually find one, and that's really surprising. Because I really thought there would be one. But I'll just start with the video. It's written by Pop Then Bop on Wattpad, link in the description below. Warning, there is going to be a panic attack in this chapter. If you get triggered easily, don't read it. Okay, or for your case, don't listen to it. It's a beloved pro hero who prides the rules and guides people, bragged Ira as he talked about his older brother. I aspire to be a hero like him one day. As such, I think I'll be too soon for me to be in a leadership position. For now, Midoriya is the better man, and this becomes the president is the right choice. Ira smiled. You, Raraka, Midoriya, stopped eating your lunches to look at him in surprise. I think that the first time you smiled, Ira, pointed out Raraka. Is that true? I smile too, all the time, objected Ira, who was trying to convince Raraka that he smiles. Suddenly, a loud siren goes off, and many people, you included, stopped what they were doing. Security level 3 has been breathed. Students, please continue evacuation, said a monotone voice of the announcement. Everyone started to panic, trying to get out as quickly as they can. What's security level 3? As Ira was confused along with you, Raraka and Midoriya. It's me, someone has infiltrated the school grounds. This hasn't happened in 3 years. A boy's glasses replied as he too was trying to get out. Following the crowd, everyone pushed people out of the way in order to get out of the area. It was surprising on how many students were actually at UA. Being in the tight place, you got very easily knocked around until you fell to the ground. People were stepping everywhere, barely missing you. Every time they got close, you always thought they'd tramp over you. Your breath got shorter and shorter until you felt like you couldn't breathe anymore, and your whole body felt numb, sweat rolling down your face as you choked uncontrollably. Your heart was banging against your chest, so hard that your chest felt like it was going to explode. Am I going to die? I'm going to die, you thought as you clutched your head. This was it. This is going to be the end. Now people pushed even harder, even more desperate to leave. Panic filled the place, and panic overwhelmed you. Alen, are you alright? Shouted Midoriya as you were trying to reach you. Despite having someone in the way, and his face pressed into the back of another person. You stared at the hand in shock, as if the hand was going to turn into a knife and stab you to death. Not being able to hold him any longer, you let out an extreme high-pitched scream. Everyone stopped pushing around when they heard the scream. Not before long, they pushed even harder than before. Now everyone is panicked even more than before. Who screamed? Are they alright? Stop pushing! Voice filled the room. Everyone wanted answers and are curious. Midoriya pushed through the crowd until he got to you. He dropped down to his knees and put his hand on your shoulder. Alen, what's wrong? Is everything alright? Asked Midoriya, who was sounded worried about your well-being. Shaking her head, reaching out over to Midoriya, and buried your face into his chest and cried silently in fear, while the room moved around the two of you. It's okay, it's just the press, Ira yelled, who had magically appeared above the exit sign. There's no reason to panic. You're at UA. Let's conduct ourselves to the manners of enroll at the highest academy. He yelled once again, and held everyone's attention. You hear that, Alan? There's nothing to panic about. Midoriya stuttered since a girl was crying over him, on him. Even then, he still tried to calm you down. Are you sure? You sniffled with a scared look in your eyes. Nodding his head, he helped you to your feet. You had a panic attack, that's all. It's normal for human beings. And Dora said it just when you were about to ask what happened to yourself. It was just a panic attack. You just sighed to yourself, praying that you would never have to experience that again. That was the fanfiction. Thank you guys for listening. And hope you have a good day. I'll see you guys next video. Bye.